What do the two brands have in common?
You know, I think what we have in common is perhaps the idea of quality. Quality and, I hope, intelligence. Because finally, it's the only thing we need. If we add on that honesty, and the honesty make the product affordable and democratic, it's enough. Intelligence, it's what? It's give the best we can to make our friends happy, to think deeply how we can help our friend to have a better life. That's all. Quality is to be sure that our friends who have worked to make money and who have spent this money to buy our product can keep this product a long time. Longevity, transmission, heritage. And honesty is to be sure there is no more marge, more value, not value, be sure that it don't sell too much compared to the real cost. After, when you have bring together all these parameters, perhaps the product will become elegant and timeless. Elegance and timeless is just what we expect from a modern product.
If when you're designing, in the design process, are you thinking of people somehow as friends?
Some people design for what they call target consumer. A target consumer, if I have an image of a target consumer, is you, me, but with a target here, with a red spot, waiting for I don't know what, waiting to be killed. I cannot imagine that. That's why I can say my tribe, my friends, my family, us, finally. But we are obliged, naturally, to think about people we love. It's simple. You know, creation is a strange job because when you do it passionately like I do, finally, is every day create Christmas gift for your friends. That's all. That's why, that's sure, it's only about love and respect.
Can you tell us something about the collection Gorenje by Stark?
The collection of kitchen appliance, it's very difficult to design. Very, very difficult. Because you are between many parameters which don't fit together. You want something which works perfectly well, with the right material quality, stainless steel, things like that, but you don't want to live in a spaceship because you are not in space. You want something cozy, human, but you don't want to live in a country farm. Finally, perhaps I have found my solution, which is to make everything at the minimum, the less possible design, and give space for the people who will use it to live in, because mainly it's their reflection. And on the top of their own reflection, we work also on the idea of a little evocation of color, because the back of the handles are colored. That means I bring the sparks of color to bring a little spark of life in all this so invisible work. But you see it if you won't see it. You have the choice. Because if you don't want to see it, you see nothing. You see nothing, you see stainless steel. But if you start to see a little more, you will see yourself and the reflect of this spark of colors. That's why, finally, it's about be very discreet with quality. And perhaps we can call that the elegance of discretion.
Can you tell us more about the challenge of designing appliances? Because they're very different, to my mind, from designing lighting or bathroom accessories or transportation.
Design a kitchen, a toothbrush, a rocket, a plane, underwear, food, restaurant, what you want. It's the same job. It's exactly the same work. It's perhaps not the same way to work, but the same work. Because at the beginning of everything, you have to understand why you live. What is the contract you sign when you're born? For me, my contract was very simple. Is you have to make something to deserve to exist. And for me, deserve to exist was serving. Serving my community. Helping my community. That's why when I work, I never think about the product. Because the product is just the result of something. I only think about who will have a profit living or using with my proposal. And what will be this profit? How this person will have a better life? It's simple. When you think like that, you can design everything. Nothing stay a secret. Nothing is difficult because it's just evident, 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 evident. You go in a simple way, just what we need and not what they need. What we need, me, my wife, my daughter, my mother, my friends, my tribe, and so on.
This comes back to your idea of democratic design, does it not?
Absolutely. Democratic design is just that. Democratic design is raising the quality, killing the price, and give to everybody. Now it's an old idea because I have invented this concept 30 years ago. That have taken 25 years to win the battle, we can say. Now it's done. We can say that almost everybody can have the right product at the right price and easy to find, which is normal. When I start design, design was elitist sport. It was beautiful design, made by very good designer, but very costly and very difficult to find. And it was bought by some few happy few. And this was not very elegant because how do you want to think you will make a modern design with the old way of doing it?
How open or closed are Stark designs? How much room is there for the user to create their own experience?
Theoretically, completely more than open, completely transparent. But after, that depends. that depend what is the proposal, what is the used. Sometimes you need things completely transparent, and I do it transparent. I have invented transparent furniture. Like that, you can choose. You can choose if you want to see it, if you don't want to see it. If you take a chair transparent like Louis Ghost, I even don't design it myself. I take the common subconscious memory of us. I think I try to find what is the first image we have in the head when we think about a chair, and I design it. And I do it with a minimum of plastic, with no style from me. This makes the biggest success of the world because it's not designed by me. Sometimes you want to express a new idea or a theory. You have to be stronger. Sometimes you want to create an experience. You have to do it stronger. That's why that depends. But mainly, I hope everything is designed not for me. It's designed for the people who will live with. If I design for me, I am completely stupid. And more than that, I cannot imagine we can have this type of success if I design for me. Because if I design for me, I shall be the only client.
Have you not designed a single thing for yourself?
No. No, because I am very bad in that. And it's even a joke with my wife. My wife work with me, and she see me every day be the worst control freak for the project I do for my partners, my clients, my friends, and things like that. And when I need something for me, I am not able. I am not able even to know what I want. That's why I don't know how to make things for me. Why, I don't know.
You're your own worst client.
I am my worst client, yes, because when I make something for me, I am not happy, and I am all right to not be happy because it's not good.
But you've been working on so many projects, over 10,000 objects and projects all over the world, and I have to wonder, where does all this energy come from?
Who knows? You know, I think if I can say it, if I am enough pretentious to say that my job is creativity. First, we have to admit that it's a mental sickness. Before everything, it's something a little cuckoo. It's something which have a relation with autism, and I am a little autist. The second thing is this idea, almost religious, even I am not a believer, that you have to give. The third is make your work only with yourself, with your brain, with your one hand, with one pencil, and one paper. It's beautiful. Guarantee of no slaves. If you are interested, if you try to understand, you see things which are not well done. You see things which are not honest. You see things which don't exist and which can be needs. You see things which happen with new needs, new parameters. And if you know how to do it, why not propose? Take the risk to propose. Me, I never fight. I am a little rebel. I am not somebody always in good mood. I am a little dark, if I can say it. But I never fight something. But when I saw something, I disagree and not fight. I have just work and replace. Why lose your energy to fight? Finally, the energy needs to fight. You just spend it to create. And if your new proposal is better, the bad one will disappear. It's what I do. It's what I do every minute, every day. I make one project by day, or average, because I work alone, because I work very concentrated, and I work very fast because it's concentration. You have to know I live like a monk, very far from everything. When you work alone like that, you can have a lot of questions, and you can have a lot of answers.
If we go back to Gorenje very quickly, how does the new line of Gorenje by Stark Appliances reflect your statement, I think the only style of tomorrow is freedom, freedom to choose what you need and what you want?
The freedom in a kitchen appliance is mainly what you will cook for your family. That will be your own fantasy, because you don't need a lot of freedom for the shape of the sink and for the shape of the bottom and for the shape of the refrigerator. The real freedom, it's your own freedom. But with Gorenje, I think it's just the reflection. That means it's a freedom to see your freedom in your refrigerator. That's all. That looks a little strange to say that. But if you are in a free to wear a beautiful, sexy, fluorescent orange skirt, it's a freedom. But that would be your freedom in the mirror.